making sure that you've got it all down, making sure you've got, you know, you've got it right. You don't want to miss, you know, anything that's coming out. And then, you know, being really on point in the room. That room, it's a collection of some of the smartest people in the world. And in season 6 and season 7, when I was there, the show was so celebrated and so, so cloistered that it was like, don't get this wrong. Mad Men was a unique situation in that Matt liked to have his assistants, if they succeed over the course of the assistant year, he liked to promote from within. So by the time I was in that room, there were two other writers in the room who had come up through the writer's assistant ranks on that show. So they both hold you to a standard because they had to do it. They know what it looks like to succeed, but they're also, they're very open to you because they know that that's the path to being a writer on the show. So I was greeted so warmly by the writers in that room, which I look back now on as sort of shocking that they were so open to it. And you slowly earn the right to chime in at the right moments. It's terrifying, but particularly halfway through that year, you have learned Matt's voice so well because you're literally listening to it as you're typing it down, you know, when he's working. So you can sort of get into the slipstream, choose your moments carefully, have good room manners, and I was able to do a little bit of it, but.